family, today we've come to christen Mr. Bryce Davis. And as we know that christenings are a time where we give him back to God. His mother birthed him and his family have come together to raise him. But we know that we can't do it without the help of God. And so today is a day that we give him back to God spiritually and thank God for his life. We come to offer blessings over his life, that he would grow into a young man that's respectful, grow into a young man that has a promising future. And this is just something that we do as a tradition before the community, in front of family and friends, to present him to the community, his community. We know that he has godparents and they're going to love on him and do what they can. But we also need this community to come together and support and show their love and raising him in the right way, and that he would always have God in his heart, that he will know God, and that he would also have an understanding of God. And so as a family, I just want to just say before we even get into the christening, and ask you all a question. Do you all commit to supporting this, these godparents, and supporting to raise Bryce and make sure that he grows up in the right direction? Do you all support
that? I do.
Yes.
And so with that being said, to our godparents, I just want to let you know that when the case that Chazion needs a break, in the time when Chazion needs extra support in raising Bryce, it doesn't always have to be financial. It can always be, you know, helping her out, taking care of him, picking him up. There's a lot of things that you can do when you see him maybe getting out of hand. You can, as godparents, your responsibility is an extension of what his guardian, his mom, his grandmother, what they do. And so he's a gift, not only just to his mother, but he's a gift to you all. They thought so much to choose you all to be those special persons in his life. And so my prayer is that as he's growing up, that you all also instill into him positive role models, that you would instill into him positive things that will help him grow to be successful in life. And one thing I like about our family, I must say, that we're a successful family. We all
have
great things that we do in our lives, and my prayer is that Bryce will grow up to follow in those footsteps that's already been established. But not only that, we present him to this community because he is a legacy of Eric.
He is
a legacy of Chastity. He is following in the footsteps of this family, and so it's an honor to just do this, not just in front of strangers, but to do it in front of families.
Yes.
And so with that, I want to offer a blessing and prayer over Bryce's life, and then we'll conclude with our christening. Let us all pray. God, we just come to you today, and we just thank you for this time that we've all come together to lift you up and give you praise, but honor you first in this place, God. To you, God, we know that you formed him in his mother's womb, but now spiritually we're presenting him back to you so that you can continue to bless his life, God. We pray now for good health, God. We pray now that success in his life, God, that as he grows, God, he will grow in power and in might, God. We pray even now that even before he gets to an adulthood, God, that you have his future already planned for him, God. We pray, God, that every person that comes in his life will not bring harm, but God, but they will bring positive impact in his life. And so, God, for that, God, we thank you for Chazion, God, his mother, God, who will be there supporting him, God, even in those moments when he doesn't know who he can talk to, God. He can come to his mother. But God, we also thank you for that extension of his family, God. We thank you for Shemichael, and we thank you for Sharice, God, who have stepped up to take the responsibility to share in his upbringing, to share in his growth and development, God. We just thank you now that you would even strengthen them as they take on this responsibility, God, that we wouldn't take it lightly, God, but this is an important role that we all should play. But God, we just thank you for everyone here as they've agreed, God, to share in supporting these three that are here, God. We just thank you for Kim and all of the support that she's offered and being there, God. We just thank you for her, God, And we pray now that she will also be a part of that role model to instill in him positive things in his life. And God, we thank you for Bryce, God. We give you praise for his life. We thank you for bringing him into this family, God. We just thank you for the legacy that he follows, God, Eric and Chastity, God. We just thank you for his grandparents, God. We just pray now, even now, but as we go into this final part of the christening, God, that you have a long, healthy, successful life. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
So at this time, as we conclude our christening, I'm going to pass him around. Y'all give him a nice kiss. So his godmother, to just offer words or some positive words that they want to share on behalf of Bryce or share to him. We'll start with you, Tazia.
Bryce, I just
want to
say happy birthday. This year has taught me so much. I never would have imagined by this time I would have had a baby, but now that I'm here, I'm just taking it all in. I'm so thankful. Everything that you're coming with, all of the crawling and biting and punching, I'm grateful.
Amen.
All right.
Amen. And I want to say to everybody that came, thank y'all for coming. I didn't expect to see all of y'all here. I just expected to be here with Bryce and you know who's going to kick it. But thank y'all for coming.
So, it's a lot for me. I'm 46 years old. My mama know. I never thought in 46 years I would have a baby calling me dad.
Oh,
that means a lot to me.
Yes,
if y'all don't know, that's all he tell mama, nana, and dad. As soon as he sees, that's all he do. But I'm glad to have you. I had you right before we were late here. But I'm happy all of y'all came.
Oh,
he waited.
This is a handful. Y'all don't know. It's a handful.
But he's so lovable.
He's just something else. I appreciate y'all coming.
Amen. Amen.
All right, y'all. This is only my second time. Get selected as a dog parent, and I don't take the responsibility lightly. I'm truly honored, Chazia and Mike and Kim, for selecting me to help y'all raise Bryce. I truly love him, and I see him as a blessing, and I just want the best for him. And I promise to love him and care for him and help to raise him in the church and do his best in school.
In the church.
Bright future, as Ernest said, that we are a successful family.
Yes.
And we just want for him to have the same opportunities that we had. So again, I don't take this responsibility lightly, and I will just do my best.
Amen.
Amen.
And so at this time we're gonna open it up to, and we don't have to do everybody, but we just wanna provide anybody from his community, his family, that may wanna offer something positive. And I know TT Kim wanna say something. So we're gonna start with Kim and we'll take a couple of more and then we'll close out with prayer.
Okay. All right. Well, this is my great grandson. Who would have ever thought that I would have had a great grandson? And let me tell you, when he was on the way coming here, I was like, nope, not me. I ain't doing it. There you go. But we say one thing and we always do something else. But this is my heart right here. This is my heart. I love him so much. And I want to thank my son. My son has really stepped up to the plate. And he has really filled in while the father has been absent. So Bryce is not wanting for anything. Shamichael has really been there. Financially, he has been there every step of the way. Now we have some help. Titi here, I know that she's gonna bring him up, and I know that she's gonna raise him in the church, even when I'm gone, or even if something happens to me. I know Sharice is going to be there. I know she doesn't take the responsibility lightly. That's why I asked her. And when I was looking for role models, I was looking for somebody that was gonna be there, that was gonna do whatever it took, regardless. And so that's why I chose, and I wanted Mike and Sharice, because they've been there every time we went to the hospital, every time Yoma Sharice was there. So, and you know, with her background and everything, I just feel like she would be the perfect mother whenever Jasmine and I would have to. Yes. So, and with that being said, thank you guys, and I appreciate everybody coming in. And so, I also want to say happy birthday, Chapa. Today is his birthday, so happy birthday, Chapa. That means, y'all, he take his time, he's doing sign language, and he's going to like come back talking about him. This means you.
Anybody else would like to have a word or say anything?
Oh my lord, I would say something, but they say I talk too long.
There we go. Well, if not, well, I want to present this certificate, and it simply says a certificate of christening. This certifies that Bryce Cole Davis was dedicated back to God in the presence of his family on September 14th. 2024. It's signed by me, and this is something that you can frame. Frame it. Don't just put it in the corner.
Yeah, because yeah. Love too. Like, would they be asking for
keeping up with
would they be asking for stuff like
take care of that?
You could use this like a birth certificate or different something. Really? You could use this that like for military stuff like that. Yeah, they say you could use a christening record.
Offering a final blessing over this day now of celebration, but also offer a blessing over the food. So let us pray.
Amen.
God, we just thank you as we conclude this christening, as we transition into a further celebration of life. And so God, we pray once again, long life for Bryce. We just thank you that he's came into our lives and made an impact, God, and just brought so much joy and love, God. You know that this family has experienced several loss in these last few years, but we just thank God that you keep adding to this family and you brought Bryce to us. And so as we celebrate his birthday, God, we pray for this meal and this food today, God, that it be nourishment to our bodies. God, we pray even now for the hands that prepared it. We thank you for all of the resources that went towards making sure this day was possible, God. Everybody that played a part, we pray for them, and we ask a special blessing over them, God. We thank you, God. We pray now that all will be well and be fun and laughter and excitement. It's in Jesus' name we pray. But before I say that, God, we thank you for the life and legacy of Agnes Clark.
Amen.
And Curtis Clark, God, because we know that this family would not be here if it were not for the roles that they play, God. We just thank you right now for them, and we remember them even in this moment. Yes, in Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Beautiful.
See,
that's what I call a good thing. I got these good things. See, I don't want to
lose. I used to hang out every night, running around in clubs. Yeah, I thought I had everything. I thought I'd never need.
Daddy baby, that's that baby. Oh, go, get a baby. went to the sweatshop.
September 14th, christen my great nephew today. And I'm glad for everybody coming out. I had a good time. Until next time, peace!